Hey everyone, so welcome back to our YouTube channel. So in today's video I will show you how to create a website with sliding text effect using only HTML and CSS. So as you guys can see on my computer screen, I will show you the preview of our website. So here is a background image with some fade effect and a navigation bar and a logo with name, and here is the sliding text as you guys can see, and here is some more text and a button, and when I hover on it, it shows hover effect and it looks really amazing. So here is the basic website with sliding text effect. So today we will create this amazing website using simple HTML and CSS. So guys, without wasting your time, let's get started. So guys, I opened my VS Code and I already written some basic syntax of HTML, and now first of all I will define a div with class name container, and in this div I will define a navigation bar. So I will write define a div class with name navigation bar, and now I will import my logo. So here I will write img src, so my logo is successfully imported. Okay, so now I will write the text here. So here I will write coding master, and okay, great. Okay, so now I will write a navigation bar. So here I will write navigation, and using an order list I will create navigation links. So here I will write ul li href home, and I simply copy this and paste it below. One more time, and just change the names. So here I will write about section, and here I will write blog, and here I will write community, and at the end I will write contact us. Save it and let's check it out the output. Okay, great, our list is successfully created. Now I will write HTML code for our content. So here I will write simply div class and class name content, and in this div class I will write all my text and buttons. So here first of all I will again define a div class with class name text, and in this I will write my main text become a, and here I will again define a div class with name slider, and here I will write div become a programmer, and here I simply copy this and paste it below, and here I will write web developer, and here I will write app developer, and it's done. Okay, so first of all I will show you the output. Okay, so now I will define a paragraph tag, and in this paragraph I will write like we are providing free content on our platforms, for future pyramids. And here I will use BR10 for next line. If you want to become a good programmer, then join our community now and level up your skills with us. Great. Let me show you the output. Okay, great. Our paragraph is successfully created. Now, at the end, I will define a button here. So here I will write button with class name btn, and here I will write join now. Save it, and our button is also created. Okay, so here our HTML code is completed here. Okay, and so now it's time to styling. So move to CSS file, and here first of all I will use the universal selector and give some basic properties like margin and padding, and here I will give font family Poppins, and here I will write sans serif. Save it, and now I will write container and first of all I will change the height here, so 100 VH, and also width 100%, and now I will put the background image. So first of all I will give some colors to add a fade effect on my background image. So here I will write RGB here. Now I will import my image here. So here I will write URL images bg.jpg. So let me show you the output here. So our background image is successfully imported. So here I will write some properties to set my background image. So here I will write background position. At background position I will set center, background size, color, box sizing, border box, and padding right 5%, and padding left 3%. Just save it, and I will show you the output here. So our background image is successfully set, and it looks really very attractive. So now let's style our navigation section. So here I will write navigation bar and width 100%, height 15 VH, margin auto, display flex, and align items center. Okay, so here is the output. So now I will style my logo. So here I will write width 50 pixel, margin top 10 pixel, padding 15 pixel, and cursor pointer. So let me show you the output. Our logo is set. Now here also I will set my text. So first of all change the color white, and now change the text transform to uppercase. Also change the font weight and font size 20 pixel. Also give some margin 10 pixel. Just save it and let's check it. Wow, it's totally perfect. Okay, now let's set our navigation. So here I will write navigation and fill x 1, padding left 480 pixel. Just save it and here it is. So here let navigation UL LI and change the display to inline block. To set the links in one line, and here I will write list style none and also give some padding 0, 15 pixel. Oh great, it looks great. So let's style our list tag. So here I will write first of all text decoration none. After that I will change the color and also font size, font weight and text transform to uppercase. So save it. Wow, and now it looks really great. Also let's add a hover effect. So here I will write navigation UL and A hover. Here I will change its color. I will write color 3, B, D, 4, E, 2. Just save it and I will show you. When I hover on it, the text color changes, as you guys can see here. Okay, great. So it's time to style our main content. So here I will write dot content and width 100%, position relative, top 45%, transform translate y minus 50%, and text align center, color white. Oh wow, great. So here I will write dot text to give some more properties to my content, main content. So here I will write font size 70 pixel, font weight 700, text transform uppercase, height 100 pixel, display flex, text line left, overflow hidden, and justify content center, and align items center. It's just a basic code. So here let's check it out. Oh wow, it looks great. So now also let's style our paragraph tag. So here I will write paragraph and give some basic properties like font size 15 pixel and font weight 500, line height 20 pixel, and letter spacing 0.1 em, and also margin top 40 pixel. Just save it and our paragraph is also set. Let's style our button. So here I will write dot button, and first of all I will change the background. So here I will write background and linear gradient to write transparent 50% and also set the color 50%. And now I will write here background size 200% auto, background position left, just save it. You guys can see the button here, it changes. So here I will write give some margin. So here I will write margin top 70 pixel, margin left 50 pixel, and also give some padding 15 pixel, padding 15 pixel and 45 pixel. Now text align center, letting show the output here. So also let's change the color. So here I will write color white. Let's check. Okay, great, perfect. So now, so border 2 pixel, solid outline, oops, none, just save it. And let's check. Okay, great. And here I will write font weight to 700 and font size 24 pixel. Oh wow, button, the button looks great. And here I will write text transform uppercase. Wow, also change the border radius. So here I will write border radius 30 pixel. Let's check. Oh great, wow, great. And here also change the cursor to pointer. So you can see here pointer cursor. And here add some box shadow. So here I will write box shadow 3 pixel, 8 pixel, 22 pixel, and RGBA 22 21 21, and 0.15. just save it. And also add our transition to show the transition effect. So here I will write background position 0.5x. I only add the transition effect to our background position property. So let me show you the output here, as you can see. But when I hover on the button, there is no effect shown. So let's code this. So let's add some hover effect here. So here I will write button hover, and here I will write background position right, and color let me show you the output here. When I hover on the button, so you guys can see the transition effect here, and it looks really very very great. So our basic work is done. So now we have to create a sliding text effect. So here I will write dot slider, and first of all I will change the color. So here I will choose this and give some margin, margin left 14 pixel. Okay, great. And here I will give box sizing border box, and now I will use animation property. So here I will write animation slider 6s linear infinite, and now I will use keyframes. So here I will write keyframes, and here I will write slider. And now first of all, at 0% I will set margin top minus 320 pixel, and at 5% I will set the margin top to minus 160 pixel, and at 30% I will set the margin top same minus 160 pixel, and at 35% I will set the margin top to 0%. And now 65% margin top 0 pixel. Here I have to write 0 pixel. Okay. And now 470% I will write margin top 160 pixel, and 400% I will write margin top 160 pixel. Okay, let me show you the output here. So as you can see the output here, our Faraday text works successfully, as you can see, and our button is also looks perfect. Navigation bar and sliding text, wow, it looks really really great. So that's how we created a basic website with sliding text effect. I hope this video really helpful for you, and I hope you guys like this video. So make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more amazing content. See you guys in the next video. Thank you. Till then, keep learning and keep growing.